First of all, thank you. And yeah, we just after the beginning, the season we had was horrible, you know, in every aspect of the game. And you know, we were lucky that, you know, we stayed together. You know, we believed, you know, it's a new team, you know, new coach, new system. A lot of new players, so you know, it takes time, you know, to get used to each other and you know, how the what kind of weaknesses, what kind of strengths, you know, each player has, and what coach, you know, expects from each of us. So you know, it took some time, but now you know, we are on a good move, and also with, you know, Marko Gudovic coming joining the team, you know, it helped a lot, you know, it helped some players, you know, to get more relaxed, you know, take the pressure out of them. So I think now, you know, we're playing great basketball. I didn't think of it, you know, until I read it, you know, yesterday, that, you know, I'm in a group of these players and legends. So I mean, it's great, you know, great honor, you know, to be in a conversation with these guys. And I'm very happy, you know, and I'm also happy, you know, that I can help the team as much as I can. And this month, you know, proved that, that I can do it on a high level. I don't know who stole the ball, but Nando, you know, Nando get the ball on the end. And I know in the fast break like this, if I'm close, that Nando will look for the pass like this. It was not the first time, so I was just ready for it. You know, even if you don't pass it, I'll just be there. You know, ready for to receive the ball. We played, you know, back to back this offense, and I slipped the screen. The first time I dunked with, you know, with two hands, and the second one we talked with Nando, and Nando said, you know, slip it again. And it will be wide open. I know that the second one was even better. You know, it was tough pass, but you know, it was getting a loop and great play. My first idea was to play handoff. I was looking for the weak side, you know, to play backdoor or something. Dragan Bender, you know, he was very aggressive on me, and I was still waiting for. I think I pivoted four times in that play, or three times. And I was still looking for somebody to come for a handoff, and on the spin, you know, I saw him coming, you know, jumping out a little bit more, and I saw the space, and there was nobody, so I went for it, and then I finished the dunk. Yeah, I was born in Ostrava, but after, you know, 6 years, I moved to even smaller town, you know, it's very like village, and there was not even. Nothing. There was only basketball club, and basically, you know, I had no other choice. And I know I was like, you know, my father played basketball, my mother played volleyball. So, but my father, you know, was a coach at that time. And from the village, you know, we came back to Ostrava, you know, to start, you know, practicing more seriously basketball. So, yeah, basically, I had no other option. I was in Slovan for 1.5-2 years, and I was playing Adriatic League, and I played some good games against Partizan, good games against Red Star, some other games, and Duško Vucevic, you know, he saw me, he talked to my agent, and then he said, you know, that he wants me to come to Partizan, then, you know. My mother went there without speaking any English, and you know, to see how it is, and she went to see practice, which was not allowed, you know, in that time. You know, Duško was very strict on these things, and he allowed her to, you know, to see practice, because you know, she was a professional volleyball player, and she knows how difficult it is for a young player to be, you know, be in a senior team and be in a men's team, and you know. She liked it, you know, and then I went there, and I, you know, I fell in love with that. So I mean, it's great that I chose this path. Actually, yeah, I talked to him 1 year before my contract expired in NBA, and I was in a summer league, And he was that was the year he was taking a break from after Panathinaikos. Before, you know, and he was just, you know, about to make the team in Fenerbahce. And I was sitting with him, I met him in the lobby in the hotel, and I said, you know, we were talking, like, how are you? And I told him, you know, he said, hey, so how are you doing? How do you like it? Do you like it here? I said, you know, it's okay, but, you know, I mean, okay, if you want to come to Fener, you know, this is, okay, I will stay here a couple of years and then I will see, you know, and I will come. And basically, next year I came to Fenerbahce, and that's how it started. 2016 was a tough one, and the next the year after that, you know, all the players, basically the whole team, you know, stayed together. And I mean, nobody ever said, you know, out loud, you know, we have a mission, like, we have to win EuroLeague. But from what I felt, you know, how everybody, you know, were focused and how everybody played, you know, somewhere in the head, everybody had that, you know, we have to win it, and we'll do everything, you know, to win it. You know, especially it was in Istanbul, it was very special, you know, to play in front of our fans. So that was, you know, even a bigger motivation. So, yeah, we never say it out loud, but You would feel this atmosphere, you know, that everybody had that mission in the head. It's a great feeling, you know. It's I'm happy that, you know, I can be part of this organization and part of this success. I mean, my kind of basketball is, you know, I try to, you know, play the best way I can to help the team. Even if, you know, I don't know, I want to score 30, I want to rebound this, you know, until we, you know, play good basketball and then win the game. That's the most important thing. So, I mean, I'm happy that, you know, we built, you know, a high level franchise here. And I hope, you know, we'll continue doing the same way, same thing. It was a good change, you know, for this season. You know, beginning of the season, you know, it was so difficult, you know, to play the game and, you know, to motivate yourself to play game, you know, when it's the full arena, even it's, you know, opposite fans, then it's, you know, you get yourself motivated, it gets you going. So it was not easy, we got used to it somehow, you know, now we are more focused, you know, to play the game. Not worrying about we don't have a fans and stuff, but you know, in the Moscow it was great change for the while. So I'm very thankful, you know, that you know, a lot of Fenerbahce fans came to support us. To be honest, I don't know. I mean, I just really try to play, you know, prepare myself the best way I can for practice, for basket, for the game, and. I also starting to feel that, you know, it takes more time to get ready, you know, than let's say it was 3 years ago, 4 years ago. I don't know. I mean, it's a different, you know, season. You know, I play more with the head. You know, I'm trying to be more focused, trying to play more smart in offense and in defense. So. I mean, both seasons have something, you know, special. So I cannot say this one is better than the other one. But you know, now as we grow, you know, in general, in life, you know, it's the same with basketball. And now I think I play more mature basketball, I would say.